We will continue from the serological methods for the diagnosis of the viruses or for the isolation and cultivation of the viruses. For the serological test, we have agglutination and precipitation tests. How to use this test? First of all, the principle, the virus can be synthesized by the specific antibody. It is the basic principle that if we have the specific antibody, we can synthesize the viruses. And if we have the electrolytes present, the virus will be forming to each other and forming the aggregates. That's why they are called the agglutination test, because the viruses will be forming the special kind of the aggregates in the presence of the electrolytes, and they are also synthesized by the specific antibodies. The agglutination and synthesization can be observed by microscopically and macroscopically. So we will see them one by one, that how to observe the viruses agglutination and precipitation by the microscope and without the microscope. First of all, the fluocination. Because the size of the virus is in between the protein and the bacteria molecule, that's why the term fluocination is most accurate and more appropriate for the viruses. The antigen preparation for the agglutination and precipitation test. Agglutination involves with the centrifugation. Centrifugation is done two times for the agglutination and precipitation test. First of all, we do the centrifugation and then wash the viruses or wash the antigen with the phosphate buffer saline or the buffer solution which may be made, and then the re-centrifugation is again occurs in this way. Just you can see the line of action of the viruses. First of all, the antigen which is inoculated inside the animal body, which we used here, is the mouse. And then antigen, it will go towards the spleen cells. The spleen cells, then maybe the cells are taken in the cell culture and used for different processes. Then the myeloma cells select and grow the hybrid cells only from the, we will use in the laboratories, we will not use the single cells, we need to use the hybrid cells from the antigen, and then those hybrid cells will be separated and allow them to proliferate into the clones. The clones are called hybridomas. It will be three kinds. First is the antibodies, and then the screen for the desired antibody, the hybridomas, and then the chosen hybridoma is then grown to produce the large patches of the desired microbacterium. So applications. There are two ways that are applied for the agglutination and precipitation test. One is you need to know what antibodies are there. If you already know, if the virus is known, then we can detect which kind of antibodies are there acting on the for this purpose. However, if we have the antibody, we have the serum, and serum is already known, we can detect which virus is there. So we can apply the agglutination and precipitation test by the two ways. We can detect the virus or we can detect the antibodies. However, it is also accompanied with some of the challenges, with some of the difficulties which are already together, because the preparation of the antigen. Antigen preparation is very difficult for the agglutination and precipitation test, because you need to use the animal tissues for the cultivation of the viruses, and viruses are grown in the animal tissues, which is not the easy way. Therefore, it is accompanied with some of the difficulties for the agglutination and precipitation test.